Due to the crisis of the economic collapse, people are becoming aware of the failure in government. They are waking up, researching, and educating themselves. The internet has allowed them to self-sufficiently teach themselves independently of the corporate-owned and biased media propagandists. They realize that real reform is needed, and Obama has not brought something that works. Therefore, the nation is ready for fundamental changes and revolution, returning to the Constitution that made this nation great. Candidates that are being offered to the people are insufficient. Many are enlightened to the fact that Democrats and Republicans bear little and zero significant fundamental difference. The candidates are being supported mainly on the idea that one has to choose between the lesser of two evils. These Wall Street elected candidates are corrupted by lobbyists and play the political game. The people have little confidence in them in such vital times. And it does not look like they have a great chance at beating Obama. Ron Paul stands apart from the status quo by a massive margin, directly and fearlessly contradicting the establishment. With many years of experience and a consistent conservative voting record without raising taxes, he was against the Patriot Act, bailouts, etc. In his proposed plan, he will cut $1 trillion in the first year. He will take the median pay of the average American, putting his money where his mouth is, to show that he is legitimate and not another puppet, but a grassroots candidate, surging because of the people. Calling out the financial sector, accomplishing the first audit of the Federal Reserve, seeking to abolish it, so that that private company cannot have power over the issuance of our currency, printing it out of thin air and devaluing our dollar, dropping interest rates, giving out bad loans, and causing the destruction of our economy. He prophetically foretold and warned for many years with specifics in Congress, telling that an artificial bubble would pop, namely that of the housing bubble. The list goes on. His time has come. There is nothing more powerful than an idea whose time has come. The nation is ripe for change and longs for the fundamental reform that he brings. He's an honest and trustworthy man because of his record, not his words, who will truly pull the troops out of the Middle East and around the world that costs us trillions of dollars and creates more terrorists than it kills. For years, a movement has been building behind him. Men and women, patriots, who are more motivated to support him because they did not just have mere rhetoric now to follow. They had in Ron Paul a man of substance, a true statesman seeking to serve the country and restore it to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, taking out corruption and restoring the law of the land. They are educated, informed, seasoned, motivated, and have many innovative tools they have used to spread the message, even without funding from the rich and corporations. They give sacrificially out of their own pockets. Ron Paul has 5 times as many small donations from individuals than other candidates. Historically, once you have a fervent, dedicated 10% as your base, you are on the verge of an explosion. It is the law of multiplication. The tide is not only turning, it has turned. He was once ridiculed and ignored emphatically. This still occurs, but it can no longer suppress him. Many newscasters and iconic figures are getting behind him and endorsing him. His policies, which were once hated, are now being adopted by much of the mainstream. Many say they have not seen such devotion for a candidate for half a century. The establishment media, corporate world, and almost every other dominating institution are afraid. The Republicans fear that if he does not get the nomination, that him leaving to a third party will destroy it. No other candidate since Ronald Reagan has brought so many voters to the party. He spearheaded and fathered the Tea Party, which revitalized the GOP after a destructive loss to a dominant Obama. If he left to a third party, his voters would go with him. He would not endorse a candidate that did not represent true America, just like he didn't last cycle. When you compare the main Iowa straw poll in the last cycle to this one, Ron Paul almost quadrupled his votes. The numbers are increasing, the momentum is building, and the revolution is surging like a train that cannot be stopped. Therefore, he can win the Republican nomination. Some states have a primary form, while others a caucus. Both have delegates which are voted in and represent the voters. These delegates hold the value of thousands of voters. Now, here comes one of Ron's greatest advantages. Even if he doesn't have the majority, and he still has a minority, if that minority is devoted and comes out in a higher percentage than the others, he can win. In fact, only 20% of the party shows up for primaries, and only about a pathetic 5% show up for caucus states. Ron Paul supporters, who have proven to show up in much higher percentages of straw polls, will also show up in much higher percentages for primaries and caucuses. Many more will willingly volunteer as delegates as an honor, and others will show up flocking in support. There will be many blue states that the other Republicans will not have an impression in. In these states, Paul will make a killing. He can also win the general election. The Republican nomination is the hard part. The general election, easy, in comparison. Once he has garnered the full force of the Republican nomination that has been revitalized and has their backing, he will also have the backing of many Democrats, Independents, Progressives, Libertarians, Constitutionalists, etc., who have switched parties just to vote for him, or they will write him in. Obama was known for having the support of the youth, but he has lost much of that support through his failed change campaign. Paul is now known for having the youth smothering his campaign, because he is not a Main Street bought-off candidate that is more of the same as a Demublican or a Republicrat. He pulls from all parties, and therefore will pull the wide support, causing Obama many problems in blue states that he would not usually have too much problem in. And Obama will also continue to lose red states, of course, in light of the Tea Party's ardent rejection of his socialism. Also, no president has ever won re-election with his present approval rating. Ron Paul has a better chance than any other candidate to take that thing. I could have said many more things about Ron Paul. Instead, I challenge you to look him up on YouTube, visit his website, or his fan page on Facebook, and learn more about him. A plea to Ron Paul supporters. Mitt Romney's campaign said this: "We respect the straw poll process. In the last presidential campaign, we were both strengthened as an organization and learned some important lessons by participating in them. This time, we will focus our energies and resources on winning primaries and caucuses. Furthermore, make sure to focus your efforts on sharing the message with Republicans specifically, because it is only them that can vote him into the nomination, or at least make an effort to get them registered. Remember that many have to register months before the actual primaries and caucuses in order to be able to register. There will also be links for this information. Be sure to spread this around. We only have till January 3rd, when this all begins in Iowa. Ron Paul has said that it is crucial that we place first and second in the early states. The time is short. The time is now. You see, he understands that getting delegates for the primaries and caucuses is where the nomination is won. We need to focus our effort and time from online and straw polls to getting our delegates. So we need you to volunteer. There will be links in the description to further educate yourself on how to become a delegate and support him. We really need delegates in caucus states especially. The only way for Ron Paul to become president is if he gets the GOP nomination. The only way for Ron Paul to get the Republican nomination is if we become delegates. As delegates, we'll be voting to pick the GOP nominee, just like the electors in the Electoral College vote to pick the president. Delegates determine and decide who the GOP nominee is. It's that critical. January 3rd,